A week out from the Voice referendum, some of our biggest sporting clubs and rock stars are throwing their voices behind the Yes campaign. And today, one of the most vocal supporters cast his vote.
7 days out, and it's pretty clear how this vote went, the Prime Minister proudly bumping the Yes numbers.
I've just had the great privilege of voting in my first referendum this century.
After overnight sharing the stage with Jimmy Barnes on bagpipes, raising the roof on the Yes vote anthem.
This is an opportunity to make history. A once-in-a-generation chance to recognise our first Australians in our nation's founding document.
So how's this for a winning side? With the end goal in sight, he teamed up with some NRL stars of the future as the South Sydney Rabbitohs threw their club support behind the Yes campaign.
Encourage everyone to educate themselves over this last 7 days before the referendum and we'll be supporting the recognition and the voice to Parliament next week.
We are so proud to stand alongside the Rabbitohs. Thank you so much for your support, because this is what unity looks like. This is how we can bring our country together.
Sporting heroes such as Nathan Cleary speaking up.
No voice, no choice. Come on, Australia, vote yes.
Is playing out at early polling centres.
I've really noticed the Nathan Cleary effect. The impact of him coming out and supporting Yes is just changing the tide, and more people are getting behind the Yes vote.
More than a million Aussies have already cast their votes. For some, the decision is really easy, but a new poll has found there's still one third of Australians who are yet to decide how they'll vote.
Look, this is a huge leap into the constitutional dark. The Yes case are asking us to sign a blank cheque on the Constitution. It's the biggest change we've ever been asked to make.
Claims today the Chinese community has been misinformed.
What we've seen on some of the social media, people saying things which are not true.
But I ask of all Australians to read what you are voting for.
Ali Donaldson for 10 News First.